You made a goal to finally start your dropshipping store, but you're probably running into a problem called information overload. You don't know exactly where to start, what strategies that you should be using, and you're probably feeling very overwhelmed. With how popular dropshipping is becoming, it is now a high-level skill that can be making you some serious money online. So you want to know exactly how to start with no confusion left on the table. That's why today I'm going to be breaking down a beginner-friendly step-by-step tutorial on how you can get started with dropshipping in 2023. So by the end of this video, you feel fully confident in the ability to know exactly how to get started. And I'm not gonna just leave it at that. Once this video reaches 1500 likes, I'm gonna give you a product list of the top 10 winning and trending products that you need to be selling right now. So if you want full access to this product list, smash that like button down below, subscribe to this channel so I can release all the links to these products and help you get started in the right direction. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into it. What's going on? My name is AC Hampton. I'm an eight-figure marketer who has generated sales just like this, all from starting and branding dropshipping stores. While doing this, I also get to teach students from all over the world how to generate results with their own dropshipping stores and make money online. If you want to experience what being a student in my one-on-one mentorship feels like, each week I get to hand out a free consulting call to one lucky winner. So if you want the opportunity of getting on this call and go over anything you may be struggling with and answering all of your questions along the way, all you have to do is smash that like button down below and in the comment section, comment the word dropship with your biggest takeaway from this video. Now, there's a ton of information out there in regards to starting your own dropshipping business, but let's take it all the way from the top. And the top is creating your online store. You cannot run an online business without a storefront. So let's hop into how you're going to get it and how you're going to build it. So we're heading over here to Shopify, and as you can see, you can start a 7-day free trial, no credit card required, and your next 3 months only costing you $1 by clicking on the link down in my description. Now, this is great for you, especially while just starting off, because you're immediately cutting down on the expenses that starting your online store can come with. So make sure to go ahead and check that out. Now, Shopify is a platform that your website will be built on and where you'll have the actual storefront for the product or products that you're selling. Now, there are other e-commerce platforms out there that you may have heard of, but Shopify is by far the most reliable and beginner friendly, so I highly suggest that you start there. So once you're on this page, you're gonna come down over here to enter your email address and just go ahead and enter that. And then after entering your email, you're just gonna go to start free trial. Then this screen will come up. You'll just do I'm just starting, click on an online store and click next. You can go ahead and skip this part right here. And then this is going to be the next screen that you see. And then here you can go ahead and just name your store. And like I said, I would not spend a lot of time on this. You don't want to overthink this. Just keep this very simple and very general. Wherever your business is located, you'll go ahead and click on next. Continue with email, create your password, and then create Shopify ID. Now we just open up a new store with the free trial, and you're already 10 steps ahead of where you previously were at the beginning of this video because your store is officially open. Now let's go ahead and get into the build and everything that you'll need to make sure that when customers are coming to your store, they always leave with purchasing something and putting more money back into your pocket. Now the first thing that you want to do is head over to your Shopify app store and search for an app called AutoDS. And it's as simple as this. You come over here to apps and you type in AutoDS and click on enter. And this is what the Shopify app store looks like. And it's going to be this one right here that says AutoDS all-in-one dropshipping. And AutoDS is literally an all-in-one dropshipping tool that you need on your online store. This app will allow you to connect your store to different suppliers that you may be wanting to use to help sell your product. It'll let you browse through potential products that you could be selling, and it even has the capability to fulfill the orders you're getting on your store automatically and send out tracking information directly to your customer. I mean, AutoDS is going to make running your dropshipping business as a beginner as seamless as possible. I wish they had apps like that when I first started my dropshipping journey, because automation is everything, and that's exactly what this app will give to you. I'm gonna go ahead and add this app into my store, and it's just as simple as clicking add app and then install app. Now that we have AutoDS downloaded, the next thing we need to do is connect this with our Shopify store. So this is gonna be the first screen you'll see. You'll go to add store, come to this plus sign where it says add store at the bottom, click on Shopify store and click continue. Then you come back over here to your Shopify highlight the actual HTML, and then go ahead and add that to your store. And it's as simple as that. And if you want to make sure it's connected, you should see your actual Shopify store right here at the top left corner. Now, before we head into the overall build of your store and making sure that you have all the necessary instructions to get your store off the ground and running, my team and I do provide hands-on, one-on-one guidance to help you directly with learning strategies of running your online store that can help you make money not just for a short term, but for a lifetime. So if you're ready to take action and start learning with my team and I by your side, make sure you head over to my Instagram at @AC_Hampton, DM me the word mentorship, or apply with the link down in my description so I can reach out and help you get started. Now that we have AutoDS connected, you're going to want to start off with importing your first product to your store. But in order to import a product, you have to know what you're looking for in a product that you should be selling. It is not smart to come into dropshipping thinking you can just sell any and everything, because that's going to cause you to spend a lot of time and money into the wrong direction. When you're scrolling through your products on AutoDS and looking for one that you could be selling, you want to make sure that the product is hitting some very important key factors, with number one being that it solves some sort of problem. Now, this is because a product that solves a problem is likely to sell for a longer period of time. Secondly, that it can be sold for $25 or more. By doing a quick search for the product on Google, you can see on average what your competition is selling the product for, and if it's being sold for less than $25, you'll find that you're spending more money in ads than what you're actually making from selling it. So let's take this product right here as an example. So this is the anti-theft travel backpack. And you can see when I'm on Google and I'm actually searching for this, you can see that most of these products are over $25, if not all of them. So this is telling me right away that this is being sold for $25 or more across the entire market. And lastly, you want to make sure that there is demand in the market for the product that you're selling. And you can do this by heading over to Google Trends and searching a keyword surrounding your product and seeing if it's on an upward or a downward trend. And if we take that exact product, put it in Google Trends, you can see that this is slowly on the upward trend. And that's exactly what you want to be seeing across any product that you're selling. Think about it, every business is based off of supply and demand. And when you see something like this being in constant demand, it shows that we should have the supply to back up the product. And that's exactly what we do with dropshipping. So now, in order to start looking for the products that you're going to want to start selling, you're going to want to go to AutoDS, you're going to want to click on these dots up here, and then go over to product research. From there, you're given a couple of different options for what type of products that you want to look at, from popular products to new products to US supplied products. And you can just continue to scroll through each section until you find a product that meets the criteria that we just talked about. And if you want to give AutoDS a try with a 30-day free trial, make sure you go ahead and click on the link down in my description to go ahead and try it out. So like I said, the first step is just going through any of these and just scrolling to find any products that we could possibly work with. So let's say this product right here is what I want to add to my store. It's as simple as this. I'm gonna come over here to import product, and then it's gonna say item is being added to drafts. Click here to view, and then you'll see your product right here in the drafts before actually uploading this to your store. Now, I typically draft the product just like this, so I'm able to work on the product description directly from the screen and make sure everything is good to go before publishing for the customers to see. And inside this draft section right here on AutoDS, you can see every product that you've imported to your store but haven't quite yet published. That's where I like to work on naming the product, selecting the variants that I'm going to be selling, and choosing the price that I'm going to be selling it at. And how you actually edit the product is you're going to click on this little arrow, and it's going to show you the product, the description, the variants, the images, and more. Now, I always suggest giving your product a catchy name and then describing what it is. So I'm just going to name this anti-theft waterproof travel backpack. So you see, I didn't just name this the product itself, but I named it anti-theft waterproof travel backpack to go ahead and customize it just a little bit to stand out from my competition. Now, by doing this, you're giving your customers something to remember you by so that they can always come back and find you, or the next time that they see your advertisement, they're more inclined to head into your store because they know it's you. And as I said, you're also going to change the pricing of your product on this exact same page. And whenever you're pricing your product, you always want to make sure that you're selling it for at least 2.5x your cost of goods. What this means is that if you're buying something for $10 with shipping included from AliExpress or whatever supplier that you decide to use, you want to make sure that you're selling it for at least 2.5x, which would come out to $25. By standing by this rule, you're going to help in keeping your profit margins on the higher side so that you can continue to keep profiting with your online store. So let me head over here to AliExpress, for example, and I'm literally just going to go ahead and type the product in. And let's take this variant right here, for example. I see that this product is $37.74. So if I take out my handy dandy calculator, come over here and type in $37.74 times by 2.5, I see that this comes out to $94.35. So whenever I come over here to AutoDS, now I need to change the pricing around that. So I'll just come over here to edit, and you see where it says sell price right here? I'm just gonna change this to $94.99. And now out the gate, I'm getting the right profitability with this product. Now after that, you wanna make sure that you're actually choosing the variants that you wanna sell. So for this example right here, there is only one variant, which is dark gray. But if there were multiple different colors, you wanna choose the ones that you actually wanna be selling with. And those variants that you decide to sell are based off of what your supplier can actually get. But for this example, like I said, there's only one variant. So once you've named your product, you change your price, and you chose the variants that you wanna be selling, all that you have left to do is click import to your store, and then that product is published and added directly into your store. So like I said, once you're done, you just go ahead and click on import. And then once you're finished with that, you'll see that it says 1 out of 1 finish, and now that product is imported. And if you come back over here to your Shopify store and click on refresh, and then come over here to products, you should be seeing that product right on your store just like this, which now at this point, it's time to get to work. Now, once you're on the screen, you see your product is imported and you actually click on it, this is what's going to bring you up the product description. Now, the product description is also known as the product page. Now, this is the part of your store that you will be leading your customers to when you're actually advertising the product and they click on shop now, they will be led into this exact product page that you're wanting them to buy off of. In simpler terms, this means that the build of your product page is extremely important to the success that you're going to have with your dropshipping store. And you have to make sure that the product page is as shopper-friendly, informative, and clean-cut as possible so that you don't give customers any reason not to want to buy from you. But before we get into showing you exactly how to build a high-converting product page, I know that this video has been packed with information so far, and we're only going to keep getting deeper and deeper into the value. So if you're having any questions about this video or about how you can get started with your dropshipping store successfully, head over to my Instagram at @AC_Hampton, DM me the word YouTube so I can reach out and help out in any way. Remember, it's not about how much money you can make in this world, but how much knowledge you can teach others to change your life. DM me the word YouTube if you're feeling stuck at all. So when creating the product page for the product that you're selling, you never just want to go off the top of the head with what you think would look good on this page. You want to use the resources that are available to you so that you can build a strong and persuasive product page. So what I typically like to do is head over to Google and search for my product. So like I said, I'll come over here to Google and type in anti-theft travel backpack. And what I'm going to do is just open up a couple different people who are selling these products. And there's two main things that I'm trying to validate whenever I'm opening up these product pages. And the first is making sure that they're getting legitimate traffic and that it's actually a legitimate competitor. And secondly, making sure that they are using a Shopify store. We never want to be reinventing the wheel. We want to allow whatever's working in the market to work for us, which is a direct reflection of everything that's going into our product page. And to validate step number one, which is are they actually getting legitimate traffic or not, is with using one of my favorite free Google Chrome extensions called SimilarWeb. So you'll literally come over here to Google, type in SimilarWeb. You'll come to this right here. You'll go ahead and click on get started and then download this Google Chrome extension. And then when you pull it up, it looks something like this. It shows you the traffic of the store. It shows you where they're advertising and their traffic sources. So to even know if this is a legitimate competitor that we should be basing ourselves off of, we need to know if they're even getting traffic at all. So if I click on SimilarWeb on these websites and it says something like this, we currently lack sufficient data, then I know that this is not a legitimate competitor. So I just start going down the line and I see, okay, which ones are getting traffic and which ones are not. Okay, this one's getting traffic. All right, this one's getting traffic. This one's not, so I exit this one. This one is, so I'll keep that. This one's not, so I'll get rid of that. And now the second thing that we need to be figuring out is, okay, are they even a Shopify store? Because we want to be basing ourselves off of our exact competition. And to figure that out, we can also do it for absolutely free by downloading another one of my favorite Google Chrome extensions called Commerce Inspector. So you'll come over here to Google, you'll type in Commerce Inspector, you'll click on that one right there, and then just install the free Google Chrome extension. And to know if it's an actual Shopify store or not, you'll see that this little magnifying glass is going to highlight. And once it highlights, you can go ahead and click on it, and you can see right away that this is a dropshipping store. I can see when they added these products, I can see their best-selling products, and I can even see the newest products that they're adding to their store. So now I just found out that they're getting legitimate traffic and these people are Shopify stores. And to take it one step even further, I'll open up another tab, head over to Amazon, and search for my exact product. Type in anti-theft backpack, click on the variant that we're selling, and then from there, I'll find someone who's selling the product, filter down by 1-star reviews, so I can see what troubles people are actually having with this product. And that means as simple as this, scroll all the way down to the bottom, and only filter by the 1-star reviews. So with examples of other sellers, and feedback from what customers are actually saying about the product in the reviews, you're now able to have the right information that help you build a strong and persuading product page selling your product while limiting the customer's concerns. And now you can use the non-copyrighted images and GIFs that you're seeing your competitors using on their website, but it's best to mix and match from multiple websites as you never want to just copy someone's entire product page. You're here to make your product page better by pointing out different features and benefits and to create a stronger sell surrounding your product, but you can utilize some of their best images and GIFs to help you do that. Let's go ahead and get into how to build your product description out, because this plays a major role in how long customers will stay on your product page, and the longer they stay, the more likely they are to buy. So whenever you're building your product page, you do not, I repeat, do not want to have a ton of text or just images while trying to portray why customers should buy your product. You need to have breaks with the customer's eyes with images and GIFs. So how you should be setting it up is by having the header ask a problem that people may be having that your product has the potential to solve, and then heading down into the features and benefits surrounding the product. So I'm going to put a benefit as the header, a short description going further into the description, and then an image or GIF that corresponds to the feature that I just listed. And how I'm going to do that is first literally just deleting all of this that is already in here. And I like to start off from scratch. I'll come over here to heading one, something like this: protect yourself and your belongings everywhere you go. This is probably one of the main reasons that somebody would buy this product in the first place. And then after highlighting this main problem, now I'm going to go ahead and introduce the solution. And as you can see, that's exactly what I did right here. So I went from protecting yourself and your belongings everywhere you go. Our theft backpacks and bags are becoming a vital piece of gear for everyone who carries their gear to school, work, around town, or when they travel, hitting all different types of audiences of people. This must-have wearable backpack is designed to keep your gear safe and you looking stylish, which is again the main problem that people are going to have now with the immediate solution. Then after this, I'm just going to go ahead and add an interactive GIF or image that's highlighting what I'm saying. And how I do that is as simple as this. So I'll just come over here to insert image, upload file, and then go ahead and select on the first image that I chose. And now you see I have the problem, the solution, and the image that's highlighting all of that together. And then I'll continue that same type of format for about 4 to 5 more features and benefits, and then we'll have our product page built. So let me go ahead and do that real quick. And then when you're finished, it should look something just like this. So you see how it's the main feature, the main benefit, image. Main feature, main benefit, image. All the way down. And then whenever you're done, you just go ahead and click on save. Now that you have all of this saved, you can actually preview it by clicking on this preview button right here. And this gives you a rundown of what your product page basically looks like out the gate. Now, one thing I definitely advise doing is having a compare price on your product page. So you see how this just says $94.99? We want to make sure that they're actually getting a good sale when they're buying the product. And what I like doing is at least a 50% off deal. So I'll take this $94.99 and I'll multiply it by 2. And that's gonna be $189.98. So once I'm back on the Shopify page, I'm just gonna go ahead and highlight this variant and then open bulk editor. And that's where I'm gonna go ahead and put that compare price of $189.98 and then go ahead and click on save. And now you can see you have your selling price and your compare price right here. Now there are going to be some apps that you're going to want to make sure that you have on your store that can help you increase your average order value, which means more money back in your pocket, and also some apps that will make your customers purchase from you. I broke all those apps down and how to set them up in this video right here. So make sure you go ahead and check that out after you finish watching this video. So now you have your product page set up, which is where you will be directing traffic to from your ads. And although it's very important, it's not going to do anything for you if the rest of your store is completely empty. This means it's time for you to set up your actual storefront and homepage, so that if customers actually decide to browse around on your site, they don't run into blank pages or links that don't work, which can be detrimental to whether you're getting sales or not. So as of right now, if we do click on the homepage of our store, you can see right now this is completely empty. So with that being said, we need to choose a theme and start building. A theme is what allows you to control the layout of your store and how it looks, and Shopify provides multiple free options that you can choose from. And if you want to see those options, all you have to do is come over here to Online Store, come down here to Theme Library, go to Explore Free Themes, and you can see all the ones that Shopify offers right away. Now, although there are paid or coded themes that you could use, I think the free option is the best to use as a beginner, as it won't slow the speed of your store down, and they're very beginner friendly. So let's take this refresh theme as an example. We'll go ahead and click on that and then add to theme library. And then once that's happening, it will say right here, installing theme. And then you wanna go ahead and publish that to your store. So you'll come over here to actions and then go ahead and click on publish and then click on publish again. And now you'll see that refresh theme is the actual theme published to your store. We'll go ahead and scroll over here to customize right next to the theme, and it will take us into the homepage of our store that we're able to customize it exactly how we want. When building your store homepage, you always want to make sure that it's as open and inviting as possible, and possibly aiming towards whatever holiday or season is currently happening. Like right now, since it's the winter time, maybe I could have people outside playing in the snow or hanging around their family, since that's what people are doing in the family time, and making my store completely around that. And I typically put this in my home image with the colors of my store matching whatever season is currently happening. Now, like I said, you want to keep these images general, and this is going to be a key thing that you do, especially when starting your dropshipping store, as you always should start off with a general store. A general store is a store that allows you to sell different products that may fall under different niches, all under one specific store. And I always suggest starting off with a general store, because this is what's going to allow you to test out different products without having to change everything on your store every time just one of these things don't work out for you. This then saves you time and money that you would be spending opening and building new Shopify stores every time you just want to test out a different product. This is exactly why you want to keep your homepage as open and generic as possible, more so pertaining to the season or holiday that is happening, as opposed to putting a product on display that might not be the same product that you're selling next month. And one of my favorite ways of finding these images that I know are non-copyrighted is using one of my favorite free websites called Pixels. So you just come over here and type in Pixel, and it's going to be this one right here. So because it's the winter time, I want to keep it generic. I'll probably just type in winter family. And I mean, this is a pretty good image right here. And I can just go ahead and click on download. And now I can come back to my store and add that image right away. And I'm gonna go ahead and upload that real quick. And this is what it looks like when you upload your first image. I'm gonna go ahead and upload the rest of this product description. And just like that, in less than 5 minutes, we have our homepage set up and ready to go. And you can see I have winter sale at the top, around the season that's happening. I have my background non-copyrighted image, all the way down to my mission statement, some collections, my main feature product, even a email collector. But at this point, you're missing one thing, which is your logo. Since we have a general store with a general store name, you got that right. We're going to make our logo kind of general. And there's no reason to spend hundreds of dollars on getting a logo made when you can head over to Canva and make one in less than 5 minutes with the templates that we have waiting for you. So just come over here, type in canva.com, and then you want to come over here to the search bar and type in logo. And you're going to see all the different logos that you can work with. I like to just choose a logo that sticks out to me and then just throw my brand name in there and then choose the colors that I want my store to be. I always suggest that when you're building your logo, you just choose white, black, and one accent color, so it's not too busy and distracting from your store. You want a nice, clean, and professional feel, and that's exactly what that's going to do for you. So I could choose this one right here, for example. Now I can go ahead and build this logo out real quickly. And I mean, it's literally this easy. Once I'm done with that, I'm gonna come over here to share, and then I'm gonna go ahead and download it. And you do wanna download it with the transparent background so you're able to throw it directly onto your store. Let's head back over to Shopify so I can show you exactly what your next steps are. So now that we're back on Shopify, we're gonna come over here to our header, and then you'll see it says default logo. This is where you wanna go ahead and change. You wanna go ahead and select an image, upload, and then this is where your logo is going to be imported. And that's it. It's as simple as that. And you just want to go ahead and click on save. Now that we have the logo in, let's go ahead and check it out by viewing the store. And if you want to view the store, you just go ahead and click on these three dots and click on view. Hey, and look at what we got going on, man. Look at what we got going on. Not looking too shabby, especially for only a couple minutes. Now that you have your homepage and your product page set up, it's time for you to get into running your ads. But in order for you to do that, you need to make sure that you have a Facebook Business Manager and Ads Manager created so you're able to connect it to your Shopify account. Your Facebook Business Manager and Ads Manager is what's going to allow you to set up your first campaign and start selling your product. So you have to make sure that you have these open. And to do this, you just come over to Google and type in business Facebook. And this is one of the first screens that you're gonna see. So you just go ahead and create a Meta business account by just typing in your business account name. And this should just be basically what your store name is called. Enter your information and then go ahead and click on create. Once you have all of that connected, you're going to want to head back over to Shopify, where you'll now be connecting your Shopify account to the business manager and ads manager that you just created. You have to connect these two things to your Shopify account in order to run your ads and have data transferred over to your Shopify account. So make sure that you do that. But in order to get it connected, you're gonna head back over here to Shopify, like I mentioned. You're gonna come over here to online store, come over here to preferences, and then you'll go ahead and click on start setup. And then right here, you're just gonna connect the same Facebook account that you just registered your business manager with. So you just go over here to connect account. Then you're gonna go ahead and click on the business manager that you just created and click connect. Checkout method, you wanna ignore all of this and just go to your Shopify online store and click save. With the data sharing part, you're going to have it automatically selected on enhance, but you wanna go ahead and click on maximum and then go ahead and click on save. Then you just wanna go ahead and connect with the same pixel that you just registered with your business manager. Terms of conditions, click agree, and then submit for review. And then once you get through that entire checklist of connecting your Shopify account to your Facebook business and ads manager, you're now ready to officially start running your ads. And I've broken down how to set up, test, and run your very first advertisements in this beginner-friendly video right here. So make sure you go ahead and check it out so that you learn the strategies that you need to be using to start making sales consistently online. Now, this video is as bare bones as it gets when it comes to setting up your dropshipping store so that you can be prepared to start running your ads and making those sales that you deserve. All the steps that we just covered are very important and aid in the success that you're going to have with your online store. So make sure that you rewatch, and continue to keep taking notes. You now officially know how to get started with dropshipping in 2023, so I hope you take advantage of it and take off. But before I leave you all to it, you know I cannot forget to announce the free one-on-one consulting call winner from last week's video. And the free consulting call winner from last week is Nathan Murray. Nathan, congratulations on winning. Reach out to me on my Instagram at AC_Hampton. We can hop on a one-on-one call, look over your ads, look over your products, and help you out with any questions that you may be having. And if you want the opportunity of winning next week, do not forget, all you have to do is smash that like button down below. And in the comment section, comment the word dropship with your biggest takeaway from this video. And if you want those 10 winning training products that I'm gonna give out to you for absolutely free to take advantage of all 2023, smash that like button below and get this video to 1500 likes. I'll see you all next week for another banger. This is AC with Supreme Ecom, and I'm out. They gon' want a piece when you got it like that. Like Jake said, we gon' spend it, get it right back. Stack that internet money till the site crash. They on-